welcome to another edition of OGR from the Michigan Audio Lab Studios. I'm Mike Abraham. This is Eric Van Landingham. Be sure to smash that subscribe button. Let's get to it, all right?
Sounds good.
All right. So today on OGR, we're going to do Ace of Spades from 1980. That's right. The Motorhead song, Ace of Spades, Motorhead. What a cool band, right?
Motorhead. Like, hell yeah. Like, very cool.
Were you a big Motorhead fan?
I wasn't a big fan. I didn't quite get the whole Lemmy is the godfather of metal thing.
Yeah.
I didn't quite understand it, but I did like Ace of Spades a lot because it rocked, and I did like that Hellraiser tune that he wrote for Ozzy.
Oh, yeah. Ultimate Sin, the album.
And what I really liked is that both bands recorded it, and I actually liked the Motorhead version better.
I've never heard the Motorhead version.
To me, it rocks. And the other thing that kind of drew me towards Motorhead was that my favorite drummer from King Diamond's band, Mickey D, ended up joining Motorhead, and that made me think, well, if Mickey D's in the band, there's got to be something to him.
Right. Well, you know, like you said, they consider Lemmy the godfather of rock and roll, and it seems to me like Motorhead didn't even really get as popular until Lemmy died. Of course, Lemmy passed away December 28th, 2015, so it's been a little over 5 years now, and it's like his legend continues to grow. Of course, Lemmy was a notorious partier, and his drink was Jack and Coke.
What a coincidence.
So now Food and Beverage Magazine has actually announced that you can go into a bar and order a Lemmy. It's been officially changed. Jack and Coke is officially now a Lemmy. So you can walk in and say, hey, I'll have a Lemmy.
But Food and Beverage Magazine is not guaranteeing that the bartenders are going to know what you're talking about.
Oh, yeah, they're not going to know at all what you're talking about. But I think it's pretty cool that even though you're passed away, you got a drink named
after you. You got a drink named after you,
yeah. And now you join the ranks of, you know, Shirley Temple.
Arnold Palmer.
Tom Collins.
So. Yep, yep.
So here it is, drinking a couple of Lemmys. Here's to you, Lemmy. Rest in peace. You did some great work. As we said, he did write some songs for Ozzy. They were very good friends. And when Lemmy passed away, that big mole on his face was actually amputated off. They did a cross-section of it, and they found out that Lemmy, that's a true story. I know it sounds like a joke, but it's absolutely true.
Sounds like you're heading for a trees joke.
No, it's true, but like trees, they count the rings on the mole, and they can tell how old you are.
Right.
And they found out that Lemmy was actually 4 years older than he claimed
Which
to be.
Which made him 74 when he died?
Correct. He was 74 when he died. And what most people don't know is that even though he died, when they cut off his mole, they found out that his mole was still alive.
Crazy right there.
So they sent it to Ozzy. Ozzy put it in a jar. And thank goodness Ozzy was kind enough to send it to us. And we were lucky enough to get it here with us today. So please welcome to the program, ladies and gentlemen, Lemmy's mole, Moley Kilmister.
Moley,
what you up to?
Just hanging out in this jar, writing songs.
Writing songs? What, you got a band?
Hell yeah, I got a band, motherfucker! I got Stuart Copeland's mole on drums. I got Eddie Van Halen's mole on guitar.
Moley, Eddie Van Halen didn't have a mole.
Yeah, I know he don't got no mole now because he had it removed. I've been keeping him secret in the stash. This guy can rip. I'm talking about this cat can't get down. He's the first mole of rock and roll. You know I wrote all Lemmy songs, right?
Oh, is that right?
Hell yeah, it's right. I wrote Iron Fist. I wrote Ace of Spades. Shit, I even wrote songs for Ozzy.
Is that right?
That's right. I wrote Mama, I'm Coming Home. It was originally called Moley, I'm Coming Home.
Is that right? You originally wrote Mama, I'm Coming Home, and it's Moley, I'm Coming Home. Well, that's awesome. Did you actually see the OGR video that we did when we did an Ozzy song?
What the hell is an OGR? Hell no, I didn't see it. I live in a jar, you dumb motherfucker. What, do you think I'm just sitting in here on my laptop? What the fuck? Hell no, I wouldn't be caught dead with a bunch of hacks like you anyway. Unless one of y'all want to be my host. Either one of y'all want to be my host. Come on, man, I'll make you a star.
Your host? You mean there were others?
Yeah, that's right. Lemmy wasn't the first. I started out on this cat named Beethoven. Then, when I was done with him, I made him a big star. And I went to this motherfucker named Bing Crosby. You ever heard of him? That's right, motherfucker, because of me. I wrote all that shit. They ain't even him singing. That's me singing.
Is that right?
That's right, motherfucker.
This mole has a foul mouth.
I'm telling you.
I'll tell you what. I think I've had enough of this. So when we come back, we're going to do this shot of Jack Daniels, and we're going to premiere the new OGR video for Ace of Spades. So be sure to stick around when we come back from this break.
That Jack Daniels looks good. Why don't you let me have some of it?
I don't think so. It says do not open, and there's a warning label that says no Jack Daniels for you.
Aw, man, don't pay no attention to that.
No.
I
don't think so.
You gotta let me have some
bad idea.
Jack Daniels.
Bad idea.
Come on, man, I'll make you a star.
No.
I'll put this show on the map.
No. Stick around, we'll be right back.
Get rid of him.
11 subscribers, my ass.
Get rid of him.
Hey, folks, Mike here from OGR. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Owl.
Owl who?
I'll be really happy if you'd head over to our YouTube channel and click subscribe.
All right, dude, let's do this. Right. Hey, what happened to your shot? What happened to Moley?
I don't know. Where's my shot?
Dude.
What?
Moley, you're the new host.
No way. What? What? No, get off me!
That's the way I like it, baby.